Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy VIII. And this is Vertical Sandwich. And how's everybody doing? We're fine! After your marathon reading session, we're dizzy. No, it's not. Alright, anyway, so we're headed to the Fire Cavern, which is the most obvious place in the map. And even the maps look better in this game. I mean, they look about like they did on 8, 8 or 7, I guess. So. Okay, so she's gonna explain how to junction magic. We won't be reading all the stuff she says. But, again, you take in the magic that you have stocked, and you can attach it to your stats as long as those stats are opened up by whatever GF you have equipped. So, the problem with that, first off, certain spells affect certain stats differently. So, like, junctioning, like, Cure to your strength isn't going to do as well as, like, junctioning Lightning or, like, you know, or, like, Blizzaga when we finally get it, which will be the biggest, like, you know, blizzard spell. And for your hit points, the best thing is full life. Full life is the best spell to junction. However, it's also like one of the best for like elemental stuff. So there'll be some kind of trade-offs and stuff that we have to do, and maybe we'll do some videos to talk about that and just talk specifically about kind of the system and the way it works. And I'll warn you if we do that, and I'll put things into skip in case you don't want to hear me talk about technical garbage, because this really and when you draw magic we'll be able to use it. We already know how to use our gunblade. Basically, we take enough damage, we get a limit break, and we can attack with our special attack. So we have to go in here. But what I was gonna say is I'll give the option to skip if you don't want to hear me talk about the technical details, because really the technical details of this game are big enough that we are going to have to deal with them at some point. I'll try to make that minimal. I mean, well, it'll be mostly plotline and fighting, and I'll try to keep the fights from being repetitive too. So our objective here is to obtain a low-level GF, they say, and I'm ready, and I'm his support! Instructor number 14, Quistis Trep! And then you choose a time limit. And the reason you choose a time limit is, and we're choosing 20 minutes, because I can't do it in 10. The reason you choose a time limit is because your seed ranking, your seed score for doing this, gets better the closer to zero you beat the boss. And we're not going to try to shoot for... So my job is to support you in battle, everything else is up to you. Fine. I should try to give her a girl's voice at least. You know, the boys often choke on this test when I come with them. I guess my charm makes them nervous.
Whatever.
I'm just kidding, just trying to keep you, like, just trying to lighten the mood or something, whatever she said, my god. Anyway, she'll blah 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 while we're running through here, and this is the first place we're gonna hit enemies. They aren't gonna be anything that we can't handle, so, and they're also, some of them are gonna be really standard kind of Final Fantasy-ish enemies. I mean, we're gonna see stuff that we recognize that have the same names as other things. And the first time you draw magic out of a monster, the spell shows up as a question mark. And that one was fire. And so then the second one was thunder. And we'll have her draw the third one. And see what that is. And blizzard. And so likely this monster can cast all three of those if it wants. That's, you know, it's a basic assumption you can make. So yeah, we got hit by fire, and, you know, we'll have one person attack and one person draw for now, anyway. We want some of those offensive magic spells to junction to our weapons, at this point, into our strength and stuff. They're decent all around kind of things to do. We're also going to want Blizzard because, this is a cavern of fire monsters. And that's the, you know, there we are, the standard Final Fantasy victory music, the do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, which if you saw Final Fantasy Advent Children, there was actually a really great joke about that in there. But anyway, moving forward. We can see where these, none of these go off screen, but like here's a draw point, and so we'll draw the fire spell. And like I said, this is pretty straightforward, although there's a boss battle in here. I mean, obviously, we came in here for a boss battle, so. And we don't want to get out of here too quickly, because like I said, our score goes up depending on how long it takes. Okay, these guys are a pain, because these are standard Final Fantasy monsters, like Bomb, an elemental monster. Use an ice attack for these. Check the monster's weakness with Scan. And like, we didn't even have Scan, I don't think. We might. We can draw fire out of these guys. But the thing about these guys, and if you're familiar with any of the biome creatures from any of the Final Fantasy games, if you attack these guys and you don't kill them fast enough, they'll explode on you, like they self-destruct, and you won't get any experience and they'll hurt you. So, what we're gonna do is, well, we're not gonna use that, we're gonna keep drawing off of him, and we're gonna have, Quistus has an ice GF, so we're gonna pull up the GF, and then we'll see the GF battle screen. Which, this is another thing that when I saw it, just blew me away. This stuff was so cool. And I mean, the stuff in 7 was good, but like, this was equally as good. They made these so elaborate, so crazy. Eventually we'll get to the point where we'll be skipping these, I'll be cutting these out because they are rather long. But we'll show each of them a couple times. You're gonna see this one a lot, because this is what we're gonna be using against the boss. And I probably won't cut that out because it's over. I mean, eventually, like I said, I'll be cutting these for time, and like if he's trying to run through the plot faster than we are, you know, in real life. It's definitely going to slow my production down because I'll be taping a lot of stuff I'm not showing. Which always hurts on my end, but we'll make it work. You know, everything else has worked so far. Even if we just post, you know, one video every couple days for this game, we'll get through it. And yes, I am running around, I'm grinding on camera and stuff, like... I'm not gonna do too much of that, but... And we're gonna junction her because I forgot to do it. It shows you how in the tutorial, but then the things it shows in the tutorial doesn't do. So we're gonna auto-junction and then we're gonna head forward. Now I'm hoping that junctioning the fire onto my weapon isn't gonna keep me from hurting the boss in here. I also should say that when you're fighting, if you hit R1, if you hit the trigger button at the moment you hit the enemy, it does more damage. And I don't know if we're supposed to know that yet, but I'm gonna do it. It's a little harder for Quistus than it is for Switch. Because, he's your main character, so I'm just used to it. And, this is the other thing about the junctioning system that I haven't talked about yet. Oh, by the way, the question mark in those bats is the scan. Did we just do it? Got it. Okay. There's something I haven't said about the junctioning, and that's that if you've got a spell junction, you can still cast it, but casting it will make your stats go down. Because you'll have one less, and it depends on how many you have, how largely it affects your stat. It's so weird. That's another thing people just absolutely have to hate, And when we get to some, like, bosses, they'll have the ability to blow away our magic. And then that affects our stats in the boss battle. Crazy stuff. That won't come till way. But it is coming, so. And because of the bomb guy, we're gonna use Shiva here, because we know that that'll kill them. So I'm sorry making you watch all these kind of pointless battles and this kind of running around. And we're not gonna have time in this video to fight the boss either, which is kind of a shame. So, but what are you gonna do, you know? Like, we're just getting introduced to this game. Like, how's everybody doing? We're fine, we're watching Creepy Blue Lady in a Bikini. Yeah. They'll do that if I can. As Creepy Blue Ladies in Bikinis. Although this stuff, like these summons, because like Shiva carries over and like Quetzalcoatl carries over and Ifrit carries over to like Final Fantasy X and the summons in there are amazing. Just the graphics for them are just unbelievable. But that was a more live action-y. This is a turn-by-turn role-playing. It's very standard. Whereas Final Fantasy X was far more live action-y, where the you enter battle sequences where the summons replace your party. So, like I said, we're gonna head on up to the boss and we'll get there, and then we're gonna cut the video off and we'll have a video that is just, you know, fighting Ifrit, who is going to be our boss in the fire cavern here. How do you know all of this, Vertical Sandwich? Well, the way I know all of this is that when I first started to do this, I set a 10 minute time limit, and I failed. So there's actually like a 15 minute part of this tape that was cut out of me failing this level. So there's my dirty little secret, it's out in the open. I hope everybody's happy. I hope you're all happy. Alright, so we'll be leaving it there, and I guess I was right, you and Cypher are in a class of your own. You both have amazing physical strength. So I'll be cutting the video off there, and you guys take care, and I'll see you for the next video. Oh, this is it. Are you ready? And we are ready. You seem confident enough.